The FA Cup, the oldest knockout competition in the world, a trophy lifted by so many legends of the game. Tonight, two sides dreaming of a date with the big boys. And then, as one Wrexham legend would tell you, anything is possible.
What does the FA Cup mean to the people of Wrexham? It's our big chance, the chance for top of the Giants. We've done it plenty of times, beating big teams. West Ham.
Watskin. Tagadrasso. Machikovlan.
Ipswich.
Cross. Cross to Durkin. Durkin on the volley.
And Arsenal.
It's Thomas who takes it. Oh, what a goal, Mickey Thomas! He's done it, the magic little man.
Can we do it again?
Wrexham have beaten the league champions Arsenal.
Of course we can.
Well, this is the man hoping to guide them towards a possible third-round upset. Kevin Wilkin, the Wrexham manager, his side mid-table in the conference and favourites to go through. Although Jay Saunders, the Maidstone boss, might just have something to say about that. Aside from Kent, two levels below Wrexham in the Ryman League Premier Division, but in the second round proper for the first time in their history, after beating Stevenage of League Two in the previous round. Yes, it's the pros against the part-timers, classic territory. The FA Cup drama. A very good evening and a warm welcome to the racecourse. Our guests, two men who've had their fair share of memorable moments, good and bad, in the competition. The former Wales striker Ewan Roberts and a man who knows this place very well, of course, the former Wrexham boss Dean Saunders. Good evening, gentlemen. And Dean, of course, you won the FA Cup in 1992 with Liverpool. Still a special competition for you?
Well, yeah, because when we were kids, we all watched the FA Cup and I was lucky enough to play in the final. And I remember walking down the steps thinking I got a free transfer at Swansea not so long ago, and now I got a winner's medal. So, first thing I ever won, and the best thing I've ever won.
And earlier on, you were on this pitch when Football Focus was on, taking divots out of the field. And if you spoke to the groundsman, have you, about that, trying to recreate that Mickey Thomas goal in 1992.
I can't believe you brought that up. My legs are gone. That's the reason why.
Ewan, obviously it's been very special down the years, the FA Cup for Wrexham, but what about the challenge this evening against Maidstone, who've done so well in the previous rounds, and all these fans behind you there, the 800 of them who are following them this evening?
It'll be a tough game for Wrexham. You know, they're going well in their division, they're second, and we saw what a good side they were in the last round when they beat League Two Stevenage. They've prepared properly, they came up yesterday, they stayed overnight. They're going to be right up for this game.
OK, well, let's hear from the man hoping to guide his side through safely this evening, the Wrexham boss, speaking to our reporter, Dylan Griffiths.
Well, Kevin, you saw Maidstone beat Stevenage a few weeks ago in the replay. How big a test will they be tonight?
It will be exactly that, a big test. You know, they're a strong physical side, good shape and formation about them. They play in the right way. You know, they can load the ball up on you, they can get it down and pass it, and you know, it's not going to be easy today, but you know, when we're here and we're at home, and we need to make full advantage of being at home and you know, making sure we're doing the job.
And arguably your best performances this season have come in the FA Cup.
You would say so, to beat Macclesfield 5-2 and Woking 3-0, two terrific performances. So yeah, if we can continue that, we'd be in good stead.
Kevin, we wish you well tonight.
Thank you.
So that's the Wrexham manager, Kevin Wilkin. Dean, you've been here, you know what it's like trying to get this club back into the Football League. What about the job he's doing here at the racecourse, Kevin Wilkin?
Well, as you said, it's a difficult league to get out of. There's only one team goes up and one in the playoffs, so it's a really tough job. A lot of expectation around the place. Win this game tonight, it helps, because the money goes into the pot and your budget is what you need to get out of this league. You need a good budget.
Ewan, in terms of the key men for Wrexham this evening, talk us through the player that you've picked out. Where's York?
Where's York? I think he's a talented player. He can play on either wing. He can play up front, as we saw in the last round with Andy Bishop. You know, I think in the first half, I thought that both of them were outstanding. Both scored, both created goals for one another. He's got pace. And most importantly, as Dean will tell you, as any winger, you need good quality in the final third. And Wes has got that.
OK. Well, let's find out a little bit more about the team that Wrexham are facing tonight. We know that they've sent Stevenage packing already, but what about the men from Maidstone?
Maidstone United arrive at the racecourse after a remarkable journey.
And the Maidstone goal, they might be onto something. Oh, the effort there. And there might be another one. This time it's a goal. How about that? Franny Collin, that's what he does.
Their goalkeeper is former Wales under-21 player Lee Worgan. And Manchester United and England star Chris Smalling is a product of their academy.
It's a Maidstone milestone. The Kent side have reached the second round of the FA Cup.
Now the Stones look for another cup scalp.
So let's hear from the Maidstone manager, Jay Saunders. He's been speaking to Dylan.
Well, Jay, it's a huge game for Maidstone this evening, but for you personally, you'll be in the director's box watching it. Can you tell us about it?
Yeah, centre forward got sent off 2 or 3 weeks ago. We appealed it, which he got off. We got a letter on the way up on the coach yesterday. We got an email saying that I was being suspended after being asked to leave the technical area, and they've took it up that after I reply, within an hour, they came back and said, well, I'll miss today's game. So disappointing, but we've got to get on with it.
And what about the following fans who've made the long trip from Maidstone? Was it 800 to 1,000 here tonight?
Yeah, over 800, I believe, and it was fantastic. I mean, the last round at Stevenage, we took 1,400, and to get that sort of support, the travelling support, away, obviously, it's a long way for our supporters, and it shows you how much the cup fever's really gripped the town.
Jay, all the best tonight.
Lovely, thank you.
So, Jay Saunders, the Maidstone boss, Ewan, he's going to have to sit up in the director's box and watch this this evening.
Yeah, he's had a bit of a disaster, especially when you think the red card got rescinded as well. You can see why he was so angry with the decision. I can't believe the FA haven't overturned his ban, and he should be on the bench for such a big game for himself and his club.
That's a bit of a blow for them, the fact that he won't be there.
We've all been there. I got banned on my first game. If you remember, when I'm manager at Wrexham, York City, my first game as a manager, I stepped on the pitch, only stepped on, kicked the ball. I got banned.
I do remember that vaguely, yeah, indeed. Talk us about the key men for Maidstone, because they've got a striker who's banging form in the league and in this competition. He's got 6 goals in the FA Cup, Franny Collins.
And someone I know quite well, he was a young kid at Gillingham when I was playing coach there back in 2005. Always had the ability to score goals. That's never been in question. What I would question is his attitude. Hasn't always had the best of attitudes, but in the last 5 years he's averaged 30 goals a season. Have to keep an eye on him.
That's the key, Dean, isn't it? Having someone who can just knock the ball into the back of the net, that's the key at this level.
It's the key at every level. It's all about your strikers. There's no use playing pretty football and making chances if you haven't got a striker who's where he should be. If you've got a poacher in the middle of the goal who knows where to go, it makes up for all your deficiencies. And when I was manager of this club, that's what I tried to do. I tried to get the best strikers in the league, and that's what you need.
Okay, well, those Wrexham players are in the dressing room. The talking is almost done. They're having a team talk from Kevin Wilkin now, and it seems Wrexham are definitely up for the cup.
They'll be wanting it as much as us. We know that they're going to come and make it hard for us and work hard, so we've got to match that.
I think going into this game, we can be pretty confident we're doing all right.
Well, there's a lot of history in the FA Cup.
It's Thomas who takes it.
Thomas. Got some great memories myself, playing sort of third, fourth round.
We'll be looking to get into that third round and hopefully being in the draw against a big team.
They're just a good, solid team. I think we're just going to have to match their work rate and enthusiasm and just sort of let our quality show.
Anything can happen in the FA Cup.
I think it's the FA Cup now. Everybody wants to play in it. It gives you that little boost.
So, the Wrexham players are definitely up for this one. How do you see it going tonight, Ewan?
I think Wrexham will have too much quality. I think if the attitude and the professionalism of Wrexham comes through, then for me, they win the game, especially if they can reproduce the form that we saw them in the Cup against Macclesfield, where they scored 5 here at the racecourse, the first half against Woking, where I think that's probably the best I've seen Wrexham over the last 4 or 5 years. If they can reproduce that sort of performance, they go through.
How do you see it going? I mean, these games, Dean, you would know this. I wouldn't want to remind you, but you went out to Eastwood Town when you were the manager here a few years back. You're on a hiding to nothing in a way, I suppose, aren't you?
Banana skins. And what I'd be trying to say to the players now is, don't get sent off. Don't give penalties away. Don't give silly free kicks away around our box. Mark your men from set plays and do all the basics properly. And go out there with the right attitude. They've got Jay Harrison
John Clark in the middle of midfield, if their attitude's right tonight and they win that battle in the middle of the pitch, then the strikers at the other end are going to get the service. So it's all about doing the basics right and don't give any silly goals away.
But we know, with these fans behind the Maidstone team, Ewan, and they would have seen last night Blythe Spartans knocking out Hartlepool, of course. They'll be fired up for this for sure, won't they?
Oh, they'll be right up for it. The manager, Dean Saunders, he'll be putting them through their final preparations for the start of the game. But as I said, you look at that Wrexham side, and I know they've been in a poor run, in only one win in 11, but I've seen a few of those games. You know, I saw them at Halifax, I saw them at Kidderminster, I've seen them at Barnet, and performances have been much better than those results show.
And just briefly, Dean, we know the money is very important at this level, 27,000 to get through to the next round.
A bit more than that, I think. That's the prize money, but the add-ons, the crowd and everything. And it goes in the pot to maybe getting the striker you really want.
OK, gentlemen, we'll catch you later. I think this lot up behind us are ready for it. I think the players are probably ready for it. Let's go and find out. Have a wander with me down the tunnel here just to see if the two sides are ready for this game and to emerge from this tunnel where so many legends down the years have come out, of course, for Wrexham. They're very proud of their history around here, of course, as it says there, the oldest international football stadium in the world, of course. First of all, we're going to go and knock up the home team down here. It's the Wrexham dressing room all the way down this tunnel, opposite the referee's room, so very handy if you want to have a quick chat with the referees. Let's see if the lads are ready. Give them a quick knock and open the doors. Lads, if you are ready, please. That's the home team there in their red and black stripes, a tribute to their 150th anniversary celebrations, going back to their original colours. And now let's go and see if the Maidstone side are ready. They've made a 243-mile journey to get here, and they're already coming out of the away dressing room for this game. So the two sides are ready, it seems. We are ready to join our match commentators. It is Wrexham of the Conference against Maidstone of the Ryman League Premier Division. Will there be an upset or will Wrexham go through? Let's join our commentary team this evening of Barry Horn and Rob Phillips.
Thanks, Ian. Well, it's a chilly evening, but with a red-hot atmosphere as the two teams are about to make their entrance to the racecourse. And, of course, that cup. They don't dream of winning it. They dream of being in the third round draw on Monday night. That's what these two sides are playing for. And it all started back in September for Maidstone with a 10-0 win over Littlehampton Town. From Little Acorns, you just never know. The Maidstone fans have travelled in real force, some 800. The Stones. And what a welcome they're getting for this second ground tie. I'm alongside FA Cup winner, former Wales captain, and of course Wrexham director and former player, Barry Horn. What an evening, Barry.
What a fantastic evening, that's right. The pitch is looking great, the weather's perfect, no wind. Good crowd, it's certainly a fantastic travelling support, I have to say. And that all makes for a good atmosphere. It's a big game, isn't it? As you say, the prize. Neither of these teams are going to get anywhere near to winning the actual prize, which is over there by the tunnel. But their own FA Cup final, if you like, is being in the draw on Monday. And who knows what the third round might bring for either of them.
Well, Wrexham, of course, were in the third round just a couple of years ago when they played Brighton and took it to a replay here at the racecourse after a terrific performance. There's Jay Saunders, the Maidstone manager, having to watch from the stands because of his ban. The two sets of teams will pose for photographs now as we remember 100 years ago when the Allied troops and their enemies forgot war for a day to play football in the trenches. Every FA Cup tie, all games today are having this photo. Referee Scott Matheson looks very proud in the middle there. But we never forget. So So let's go through the teams. Wrexham manager Kevin Wilkin makes two changes. Combinant Jay Harris comes into the midfield in place of suspended Robbie Evans, who failed to have his midway red card against Rovers rescinded. Wolves lonely Jonathan Flack is in goal. Captain and former Chelsea and Swansea player Steve Watt is ruled out with injury for Maidstone. Their danger man is, of course, striker Franny Collin. He netted both goals for the Stones as they dispatch League Two Stevenage in round one. And as I've said to you, the referee is Scott Matheson. So Jonathan Flack, what a big night for the Wrexham goalkeeper, 20-year-old on loan from Championship side Wolves, and tastes the special atmosphere of the FA Cup for the very first time. At 32, Andy Bishop, the striker, is the oldest player in the Wrexham side, but he scored twice against Macclesfield to put the Dragons through to round two and delivered again against Woking to bank this home tie. And in the Maidstone goal, a Welshman hoping to keep up the Wrexham attack, Lee Wogan. He's been on the books of Cardiff City and Merthyr and wore his country's colours too, with appearances for the Wales under-19s and the Wales under-21s. And the referee, hidden by Joe Clark, the Wrexham captain there, is Scott Matheson. 23 yellows and 4 reds for him this season. Jamie Coyle, the Maidstone player coach, is their captain. Here's Scott Matheson just shaking hands with his officials. Both sides in a huddle now. Last few words with the eyes of the nation watching. And Barry Horn, what is actually said in these huddles?
Do you know what? I've got no idea, because when I was captain of Huddersfield, we used to do it for a short while. And after the second or third week, I was running out of things to say, to be honest with you.
And there's Jay Saunders. How frustrating for the Maidstone manager. His fourth season as manager. He coaches at their football academy as well. So it's Wrexham of the Vanarama Conference to kick off playing Maidstone United of the Ryman Premier League. 36 places between these sides before they arrive today. We shall see if anything can separate them this evening. Wrexham to kick off. Connor Jennings stands over the ball. They will be favourites, but this is the FA Cup. That counts for nothing. Early touch for Jay Harris, the former Everton player. Carrington. Neil Ashton was in the Wrexham side that played against Brighton. Mistake by Joe Clark, the captain, but Harris, tenacious as ever. And that'll be a free kick. 22 years since these sides last met. And believe it or not, it was a goalless draw a week after that Wrexham win against Arsenal. Crossing to the box early work for Lee Wogan, the Welshman. Teasing cross from Neil Ashton, Barry Horn.
It's a good start from the home team, actually. Jay Harris getting involved. And the cross from Ashton with his weaker right foot, overhit, but for a split second, I just thought that Lee Wogan had got himself caught underneath that, but he gathered it safely.
But if header from Blaine Hudson, signed from Cambridge in the summer.
It's a big crowd favourite, Blaine Hudson, having a good season. Had a little spell where he couldn't stop scoring early in the season.
Ashton gets the throwing back from Jay Clark. And good layback by Jennings. Harris looks for the youngster, Ross White. Harris again. Jennings just operating behind the front two. Crosses into the box once more. York is there! But easy for Wogan.
Jay Harris involved yet again, and he looks like he's up for it tonight. And when he's in the mood and in form, there's no better player, certainly in the conference. Decent cross, as York just caught between the two defenders. Couldn't generate the power on the header. But a good start continues.
After a dominant opening by Wrexham, who are 12th in the conference, or we're going into this afternoon, they had to play against Macclesfield in the fourth qualifying round, drew the first game, and Maidstone win their first corner, won the replay and then beat Woking in round one. But they're having to defend the corner here, and we'll see maybe just what this Maidstone attack is all about. Matt Bodkin played with Ewan Roberts at Gillingham. We'll take this corner, a little usual pushing in the box. They'll want to test Jonathan Flatt early. That's not the best corner from Bodkin.
No, they've obviously worked on that. They set themselves up at the edge of the penalty area. Good movement from those that are hoping to attack the ball, but if the ball doesn't come in the right area, it's all to no avail.
Into the middle again, and Flatt holds it. And he'll want to get a few early touches like that. He'll appreciate that. He's on loan from Wolves. Daniel Backman, also on loan from Stoke City, took his place on Tuesday against Bristol Rovers, but Backman not allowed to play by his parent club, Stoke City.
Well, if there's ever, you know, a good example of the benefit of going out on loan for a young player, you look at Dan Backman and John Flatt here, playing in front of a big crowd in a game that really means something.
Looking to make progress, can he get the crossover? He can. Bishop has pulled away. Carrington was in there too. Breaks a Bishop, and it just eluded Jennings.
Terrific play again from Wrexham. Good movement, plenty of people in the penalty area. Good deep cross from York. Just checks back here on his right foot, whips it in. Bishop on the far post was really well to knock that back across the danger area, and then his volley. One thing or the other, it's just not far enough off target for Jennings to get onto it.
I think Kevin Wilkin will be quite happy with the start by Andy Bishop. But Maidstone have a throw. This will be Aaron Simpson. He's only 17. He's studying media at in college. Looks up the line for Jay May. But May couldn't control it. He's got 10 goals this season, Jay May. And with his strike partner, Franny Collin, is prolific. Collin has 16, six of which are in the FA Cup. As I said, they started with September the 13th that Maidstone started this cup run of theirs. They're into round two for the very first time since they reformed in 1992. Hudson will loft that into the Wrexham half. Bishop beaten in the air though. As Fisher trying to seize onto that. Youngster White wins a throw. It's Alex Fisher. He's a carpenter by trade. And Mickey Southall directing operations on the side for Maidstone, with Jay Saunders, the manager, in the stands. Smith's ball is cut out, but Harris will be there for the second ball. Now Jennings deeper. Ashton is always keen to get forward down the left-hand side. Skips around Bodkin. Ashton towards the penalty area. Well, made a bit of a meal of it, Barry.
Well, early on in that move, the referee played a good advantage. There was a foul on Jay Harris. He kept the move flowing. Neil Ashton there just trying to go past one man to him. He had a nice easy pass inside him. He had two passes on inside him, actually, just trying to go for the middle.
Ball by Clark. Breaks a Jennings chance here for Carrington. Lovely save by Morgan. That was important. Mark Carrington ghosted through there, but the danger isn't cleared by Maidstone as White breaks down that far side. And a header across the face of the goal by Jennings.
Wrexham should have opened their account. If not with that, the first chance, Carrington, when it came back in, that's another good opportunity for Jennings coming in on the far post. Is the last one. Good deep cross again, this time from the right. Jennings just trying to pick his spot inside the far post. And this one a little bit fortuitous. The bounce falls nicely for Mark Carrington. Good strike, but the keeper's taken up a fantastic position there on the edge of the six-yard box to narrow the angle.
There's Connor Jennings, former Scunthorpe player. Also got cut shots, there's Connor Jennings, scored twice last season for Macclesfield against Swindon. And a 4-0 win.
Oh, good work actually after that initial chance from Cancer, the shot blocked. It flew out almost towards the halfway line. And Harris didn't give up on it, he won it back really quickly. Free and White to put that ball in.
Great day for Maidstone United. Reformed in 1992 when the old Maidstone went out of business. Remember, they were in the league for 3 years. But a little like Newport County, the story there that they're coming back. They were relegated seven divisions when the new club was formed.
Absolutely, it's a great story, and they're in fine form, fine nick to get up again this time, aren't they? Second with a lot of games in hand.
Games in hand over the leaders, Margate. They've won 15 times. They haven't to defend here, though. Blaine Hudson up for Wrexham, but can't direct the header towards goal. And there's a breakaway by Bodkin. Bodkin. Hudson has got back, but Bodkin cuts in and can't find a yellow shirt. It was Alex Fisher who was coming in. He's kept the ball in again until it's cleared heavily by Jay Harris.
Not a warning for Wrexham. I mean, they have been totally dominant in these few minutes.
That's a lovely ball by Carrington into Wesley York. York has got plenty of company.
It's another chance. Wrexham have been totally dominant, but that counter-attack there, Bodkin made some terrific ground on the right-hand side. His ball in was a good one.
It's Simpson who got the ball away, but they've not cleared it again. This is Bishop. White is overlapping, it goes inside to Harris. Morgan, did he slip as he went for that? Kept it in.
It looks to me as if Lee Morgan actually had to make a save there. Seems to be going wide. I don't know if he's lost his bearings or if he has slipped. It certainly wasn't going in, that was it.
31 now, Lee Morgan. Spell at Cardiff and Nurtha 4-2 Fisher. When he's held it in, he'll give White a test on that Maidstone left hand side. This is Jamie Coyle, the player coach, part of the management team, Crystal Palace trainee. They don't have a postman, Maidstone, which is always a disappointment in the FA Cup, but they do have a glazer and a carpenter. And they're having to defend now with York into the box again. That's a great save by Morgan once more. Bishop can't make anything of the rebound. And Lee Morgan, and there's only 10 minutes gone, but he's having one of those games, maybe, Barry Hall.
Well, it looks that way, doesn't it? Another fantastic chance. And this time, there's Morgan. He had Neil Ashton on the overlap. Chose to go at himself, cut back onto his right foot. And he's brought a fantastic save there from Morgan, you have to say. Nothing wrong with the effort from York there.
So at the moment, the favourites are on top, but they haven't made the breakthrough. Clark exchanges passes with Jennings, but Sonny Miles will make the most of that. Clears up to Franny Collin. Robbed by Smith, though. Manny Smith. Clinton looks up, he decides not to cross. Clark tests Morgan from distance, but Morgan has been equal to everything so far.
Yeah, any goalkeeper's going to take some beating from that distance, but he's proven himself to be difficult from much closer in.
That's
terrific
the save
effort
Morgan made from York.
Fantastic effort and a brilliant save, just clawing it away.
Might have taken the deflection, that was Hudson. Pushing me then, referee right there. Collin is just offside. Franny Collin was at Gillingham. Offside that time though. for what he's making of this, Jay Saunders, the Maidstone manager, Barry Horn. Will he be concerned at the amount of possession Wrexham are winning?
Well, you know, we're 12 minutes in, and it has been an absolutely, totally dominant start from Wrexham. You would have been expecting something of a testing early on. You'd just be happy that they're not behind at this point, to be honest with you. There was a spell for 6-7 minutes where I thought maybe Maidstone were going to come into the game, but Wrexham have just picked up again and gone on again and have totally dominated his opening exchanges.
There are the possession stats, yeah. 66% for Wrexham.
Well, look at the second one now, 7 attempts on goal, 4 on target. That is a whirlwind start.
But no breakthrough.
And that's the worry, obviously, in any game, when, you know, whether it's a Premier League game or whatever level, when you are on top like this, you have to get the goal. I'm not saying that Wrexham won't continue to dominate, but you can expect Maidstone to have a chance, you can expect them to have a little spell of their own. And the thing for Wrexham to know is just to maintain the intensity and just keep going until they do get the breakthrough.
The clearance there, Lee Morgan, almost his first mistake of the night.
Well, that's the last thing his team need, really, to be giving the ball back to Wrexham. They're finding it hard enough to get it off them in open play.
White looks long, York beaten in the air by Simpson. Bishop loses out to Parkinson. And a chance for Maidstone to maybe make some progress down there. Right-hand side, Colin inside to Parkinson again. Parkinson looks for the run-up wide by May, and it's a lovely setup, and it's a setup for Fletcher, and Flatton had to make two good saves. Fletcher really tested him, not cleared yet. Bodkin will try to make the most of this. Brings in Simpson. Simpson, good cross in, and it was Smith who got the ball away, and then Bodkin's shot is blocked. And that's much easier for Jonathan Flatt.
Well, right on cue. Exactly what we're talking about. Maidstone will have chances. They will have moments. And it's a fantastic switch from Robinson, from Parkinson, rather. The second time he's done that. And the ball in is terrific. And you'd expect Fletcher to score from there. He hasn't, only because of a great save from John Flatt. That's a warning.
So, Jonathan Flatt is in the action. And the last effort was by James Rogers. Here come Maidstone again. Ball looking for Colin from Parkinson.
It's the third time, isn't it? More or less exactly that same ball. Right-hand side of midfield, quite deep. Just a big switch over the right side of Wrexham's defence, and they've nearly had something out of it on each occasion.
It's a good game. 15 minutes gone, and both sides have had chances. So, May's run off the ball then. Harris looks for Carrington. Deft touch, but Bishop is beaten. This is Bishop again. Jennings can't quite control that. Simpson is in straight away, the youngster. He's a teenager, but he's full of confidence, and they're really happy with the way that he's come on this season. Aaron Simpson. Bodkin is fielding it right back. Delivers that onto the head of Blaine Hudson, who seeks refuge from a throw-in.
Yeah, Maidstone happy to throw two or three men forward on the counter, but they're good play, actually, from Bodkin on the right-hand side of midfield. And Simpson looking like he was going to bomb on. Bodkin just sat back and made sure they had cover there.
Touchdown by May. Just ran away from Bodkin. Carrington is tackled, but Harris looks at the run of York. York finds Bishop, but it's Rogers who's back there. And Parkinson tries to free Fletcher.
For once, Parkinson's pass doesn't come off. Just a bit hurried with that one, snatched at it a little bit. But you can see that's obviously something that they're going to try and do throughout the game.
We apologise for the language there, if you might have picked that up on the pitch microphones.
This is Harris. And it's Jennings. White is forward and with some aplomb. Can he deliver a good cross? Well, didn't beat the first man, but he does win Wrexham's first corner.
Playing very narrow, Maidstone. Too narrow, really. That was an easy ball out to White from Jennings. Just slightly overhit, pushed him a little bit wider and a little bit deeper than he would like to have been.
Clark, the captain, strides towards the edge of the... into the six-yard box. Neil Ashton, the left-back, as he does, will take an in-swinging corner from that right-hand side. Ashton takes it. Hudson just eluded him. Does Ashton keep it in? He does. He lobs it in once more. Oh, no, I think it's a corner.
Yeah, it's gone out. The players were appealing for a corner. Neil Ashton just played on just in case. Lines was a bit slow, I think, getting his flag down there.
Well, with Smith, Bishop, Hudson forward. They don't lack height at Wrexham. Clark is making a nuisance of himself inside the six-yard box. There's a crowd of Wrexham players. There they are over the penalty spot as Ashton delivers once more. Deeper this time. Pushed away by Morgan, but driven in by Manny Smith. Well, they waited and there's celebrations on the side because Emmanuel Smith has broken the deadlock for the home side and they finally have their reward for their busy start.
Well, an anxious wait as this ball crashes down. Morgan's under immense pressure from his own defender there, causing a problem. Smith crashes it against the bar, and then there's just that anxious wait to wait for the whistle and the flag. And there's a little delay, good delivery, and you can see Morgan is impeded by his own player there. Terrific effort for Smith to get to that, and not only get to it, direct that powerful shot goalwards off the underside of the bar. It was over the line.
Yeah, referee, I don't think there's any complaint about that, is
both
there?
Took a second to think about it. Anxious pause, goal. And that'll be a massive, massive relief for the Wrexham fans and the manager and coach because, you know, it's almost now as if they can relax it. They've got the nose in front of them. A terrific start, 20 minutes coming up on the clock. And, you know, that all that good work and those chances, they've eventually got the lead. And now they can maybe relax a little bit. Not that they haven't played really well up to now, but certainly that first goal, you know, is very, very important.
Manny Smith, a bit of a cult hero here already,
absolutely,
isn't he?
He's having a fantastic season, absolutely fantastic.
And that's his first goal. Ashton to the ball forward. Harris is picking up a lot of that second ball. Carrington on halfway. And the big question now, Barry Horn, is how Maidstone react.
Well, I don't think they'll change the game plan too much at all from here until maybe the last 10. See how the score goes later on. They stick at it. We've seen them have a chance already.
Jennings has taken up a good position. Allows Ashton to cross. Cleared away to Bodkin. Hudson is in quickly against May.
I think it's equally important to, you know, to look at how Wrexham react, because what they don't want to do really is sit back and sit on that one goal lead, because, you know, they've been so dominant, they really should be going for a second to give themselves a bit of breathing space.
So Emmanuel Smith's first goal of the season has given Wrexham advantage, but you will be well aware, I'm sure, that Harleypool took the lead against Blyth Spartans last night. And look what happened there. It's the magic of the FA Cup. I think now people like Jay Harris come into their own with his experience. Wrexham looking for a second, though, with Jennings. Has Ashton in support if he wants him. Goes back to the left back now. Clark. Does he try a shot? No, he doesn't. He picks up Bishop. Jennings! Good block, though. Oh, Morgan thought about coming. He was caught out then. He
He came and stopped and was very grateful to see Wesley York head wide, Lee Morgan.
Nice build-up play once again, lovely little set-up ball on the edge of the penalty area, just a bit short for Jennings, enabling Cole to get the block in. And as it loops up, Morgan's all over the place there. I think if he'd carried on coming, he would have been favourite for that.
They've only lost three league games all season, have Maidstone. And their last one was 2-0 against the Metropolitan Police. And that was only 2 days after they'd beaten Stevenage in a round one replay, so it was sort of understandable. Because these guys are part-timers. It should be easy for White to deal with. Flat. Gets it away, but it's picked up by Parkinson. Jennings now, as Wrexham look to break forward again, and it's interesting, Barry Horn, Neil Ashton and Ross White have both been involved in attacks, the two fullbacks. Jennings this time though, looking for Bishop, important intervention there by Sonny Miles, and again, Mixor Harris, just off radar, just.
Yeah, the two fullbacks are getting forward every opportunity. Kevin Wilkins obviously set his team out to go and take the game to the lower league team. And it's interesting also, actually, I've never seen Mark Harrington get in the box as much as he has done tonight. You know, they've obviously gone, you know, to attack this Maidstone team, and so far it's paying off.
Smith, the goal scorer, determined as ever. This is Parkinson, who looks bit of quality in that Maidstone midfield, picking out passes, did a simple one there. Not only plays for Maidstone, he's head of their academy. Goes to ground. No foul, says referee Matheson. So Sonny Miles, signed from Tonbridge Angels, clears away, and Maidstone look to set an attack going themselves. Collins, ball through to Fisher. Smith has to get there, he doesn't. Ashton has to deal with this and takes no chances.
Fisher again, causing problems. Not quite sure that he should have been allowed to get in there so easily. Comfortably got to that ball with a bit of time. And it's a good cross in as well. I think Neil Ashton making the right call there, man behind him.
So it's the personal trainer, Matt Bodkin, with this corner for Maidstone. Looking for a swift reply to the Wrexham opener. Didn't get it that way, it's hooked away, but only as far as Mills. Mills launches it back into the box again. It's knocked down by Parkinson, but that's easy for Jonathan Flatt. Looking at it, that save by Jonathan Flatt just before the goal could prove really important for Wrexham.
Well, it was important, there's absolutely no doubt about that, because Maidstone get the nose in front at that point. You know, obviously the game changes significantly and they've got something to hang on to. I'm not saying that Wrexham would have gone the remaining 75-80 minutes or whatever it was without scoring, but clearly it makes the job more difficult, and it was a good save as well.
This is Fisher again, but the ball just runs past him, and Clark, Wrexham skipper, does the dirty job for his team. Dare I say, Barry Horn, like you used to do for Wales sometimes. Often.
I was going to say always, I think, to be honest, Rob.
59 times capped. Barry Horn, proud of every one of them. In fact, Kevin Ratcliffe always tells me, Barry, they say, you mark him, and we'll play 10 against 10. Is that the team orders you used to have?
Well, in those days, well, still today, I suppose, you know, the star player was always someone who was playing in my part of the pitch, so it was almost became, you know, that became the job, really, was to, whether it was Schifo or Mateus or whoever it might be, we'll take our chances with Rush, Saunders, Hughes, and Neville Southall, of course, the best goalkeeper in the world, so we were always in with a chance.
There's Jay Saunders. He played at Gillingham and Gravesend and Northfleet. He coaches at the academy. And if you work it out, if Jack Parkinson is the head coach, he's probably under the player he's picked.
Well, whatever the pecking order is over there, they're doing a decent job. A couple of players tonight have come through and combining down the left-hand side, Mills and Flishett.
Well, that was... Did he get that wrong then, Scott Matheson? I thought that came off Emmanuel Smith. White the teenager. Get too much distance, but Harris improves on that.
It's interesting, isn't it? How often do you see, that's what I was talking about earlier, completely dominant team, 0-0, you know, it'll be 20, 25 minutes, they get the goal, and then almost inevitably, you know, subconsciously, they sit back. And since that goal, Maidstone have had more of the ball, they've had more territory.
Fisher's been a real problem. And there's a good chance here, everybody left it, but Flatt makes a save. It's Parkinson again, and they still can't put it in. It's headed over the bar by Colin.
Well, that is as good a chance as any that the Wrexham have had. Fantastic breakdown left, another great ball in, a dummy when he might have taken it on, and the shot has brought a fantastic save from Flatt. Once again, Loney has saved his team there. Terrific burst from Mills, he's got great pace, the cross in is superb. Parkinson's strike, there's nothing wrong with that, it's a great save. And then the little chip ball in, and Colin can't quite turn it goalwards. Another warning for Wrexham.
The Stones have shown their teeth there, have they not?
Just as I was saying, Wrexham sitting back subconsciously, Mason coming into it, with more possession, more territory. Just as the words are out of my mouth, they should be level. It could certainly have been level there, but for a great save with his legs.
Pat Mountain, the Wolves goalkeeping coach, turned up to see Jonathan Flatt in midweek against Bristol Rovers, only to find that Daniel Backman had been preferred. He enjoyed the game anyway, I'm sure. But I'm sure he'll be watching this, as they will be in the Spitfire Lounge in Maidstone. This game being shown there tonight. Not too happy there, I'm sure, but still in this match, very definitely. Smith, the goal scorer. Just 19 minutes separating the sides. Simpson drives it over towards Flisher, who's been the danger man for Maidstone. Carrington is back there. Rogers, Parkinson, touch back by May, Parkinson, late on Harris. Just a little word, I think, from Scott Matheson.
Well, he's gone for the ball, Parkinson. DJ House has got there ahead of him. I don't think there's anything, there's too much intent in that, and quite rightly, the referee just had a little quiet word, and the free kick is sufficient.
Bishop is under this. Morgan watched it all the way and immediately frees Bodkin.
Good play from Carrington down at the right-hand side. Good technical ability, both feet. The cross is always slightly behind Andy Bishop. He's going to really struggle to generate the power from there.
It's been a decent game, hasn't it? The other side are sitting back here. Oh, that's a terrible ball infield from Jennings, and Fisher goes through. But the goal scorer, Smith, is there. Hasn't forgotten his defensive duties. Not the best clearance, though. Breaks to Colin. Colin, lovely weaving run until Jennings atones for his error. Now York is in behind the Maidstone defence here. Chance for where's York? Can't get her away. He does now.
Well, what a fantastic passage of play from that moment when Connor Jennings, I don't know what he was thinking there, because unless he couldn't see the Maidstone play, I'm not sure. Dreadful pass, set them on their way. Manny Smith to the rescue, and then an absolutely sensational ball over the top from Joe Clark.
It's a terrific game for us to watch. I wonder what the Wrexham manager, Kevin Wilkin, is making of this. He's with Dylan Griffiths.
Kevin, you're ahead, but Maidstone certainly at a threat.
Yeah, you know, whilst, you know, we've stopped passing the ball short and we've made a game very long and opened the game up, and, you know, that's given them a bit of impetus and allowed them to, you know, come more into the game. Keep a game short and pass the ball like we can, and, you know, the first 15, 20 minutes, there's only one team in it, and we should be, you know, we could well be home and dry now. Every sporadic moment they get, you know, if we don't kill the game off, it's going to cost us.
Kevin, appreciate your time.
Thank you.
Which is a fair summation, Barry Horn.
Yeah, absolutely. But another chance there from Wrexham on the back of that moment of madness, really, from Conor Jennings, because he gave the ball initially to Fisher, and then we gave it. Wrexham gave it away again to Franny Collin. Two of the most, the three big threats they've got in the team, Maidstone. So it's a little let off, really.
Now Jay May was injured there. The only goal so far from this man, Manny Smith. Already a hero at Wrexham, and he's done himself no harm there either, Barry Horn.
Well, the fact that flew in off the underside of the bar might have given the referee might have saved him a problem, actually, because he would have had to make a decision there on Manny Smith being pulled as he's reached for that shot.
Jay May is still down on the touchline. Looks like a left hamstring, and well, he won an appeal against a red card to play in this game. And it'll be a big blow if Maidstone lose him. 10 goals, 26 goals between him and Franny Collin. He's coming back on, though. He's going to give it a go. Hamstring, is that why?
I'm not sure it is a hamstring, to be honest. It looked as if it was a little bit higher up to me, but if there's any suspicion or suggestion that you've got a hamstring strain, then the last thing we really want to do is to be
keep running on it. No. There's a wrestling match going on there between Bishop and Sonny Miles. Harris keeps one way, then shoots. Easily plucked out of the air by Worgan, who sends Fisher down the left side. Clark is there again.
Good work from Clark, coming defensively there. Nice strike from Jay Harris, left foot. Always a nice height for Worgan to save, but again, impressed really with his starting position. You know, he made that save look so easy because he was 4 or 5 yards off his line already.
Well, I will say, the ambition of both sides is as it should be in the FA Cup with the third round tie at stake.
Well, you know, in those open exchanges, it was difficult to see what Maidstone were trying to do because they were pegged, you know, they were pegged back completely by Wrexham. But there's no way that you could say they've come here to sit back and, you know, to try and limit Wrexham. They've gone for it every time they've had the ball, they've pushed men forward, and they've had their rewards. They've had a couple of really, really good chances. They're making a really open, exciting game of it.
You'd have to say the two goalkeepers are as good as there is on the pitch at the moment. It's Ashton. Not sure he meant that. So the kicks the air in frustration of that cross.
It's another nice move. Fantastic ball inside the well, he's not actually the fullback, he's in the fullback position there. Matt Bodkin, and Ashton for once just doesn't get his cross right.
Dizzy Worgan. Still back in the FA Cup in 2002-03 season. Just another part of their long journey, which they hope will end, as with Newport County, back in the Football League. We have to say the Maidstone fans, you can see in that stand there, have really turned up in numbers to support their team. In the hope of being number 47 in Monday's draw. That'll be the number all Wrexham and Maidstone fans will be looking out for, number 47, 7 o'clock on Monday night. Will it be Wrexham? Will it be Maidstone? Will it be Wrexham or Maidstone with a replay to come? Wrexham have the upper hand at the moment. It's by no means secure. White tries to make it more so. Hoofed away by Jamie Coyle. for Wrexham's third corner. They've not given up hope yet.
No, there's a long way to go yet.
There's a long way home for them as well.
Whatever happens.
Ashton again trots across to the right to take a left-footed in-swinging corner, and there you see a big gap between the Wrexham players ready to move in, and Clark was inside the six-yard box. Now they spread all different ways. Morgan fouled that time by Joe Clark. Don't think he's going to get away with that.
Very similar to the delivery and the final outcome, really, from where the goal came. Neil Ashton just dropping it on top of Morgan, Clark in front of him. I think it's the skipper behind him, Jamie Coyle, for the goal. It was Coyle actually got in Morgan's way here. The referee has adjudged that Clark's doing the fouling. Difficult to see from
you
that.
You see an awful lot of players, awful lot of teams do that. And often the man on the goalkeeper is the one penalised.
Yeah, well, you know, goalkeepers are, they play specialist position, they are special players, and any sort of contact in that sort of circumstance, invariably it's a free kick. Foul on the goalkeeper, a free kick to relieve the pressure.
I'm talking of that. Apparently Maidstone think that there was a foul on their goalkeeper Lee Morgan for Manny Smith's goal. I'm sure the boys will look at that at half time.
Well, as I say, the two, that last corner there and the one from which the goal came, almost identical in player placement, the delivery of the ball. But I'm not sure that it was Joe Clark that caused Morgan to have a problem with the one from which Manny Smith scored.
Dean Saunders and Ewan Roberts will be the former Wales internationals running the rule over the first half action at the interval. Never ever had fallout to the referees, either of those two, did they? So we're approaching the last 5 minutes. This is Bodkin. He's robbed by Ashton. And that Bodkin hasn't had much change out of Ashton so far. But Parkinson, his good balls forward, and it breaks for May, recovered from injury. Mills is on the overlap. Is he got a right foot to shoot? No, he puts it square to Parkinson. Simpson is joining in. Maidstone have three in the box here. He can't be found. Headed out by Clark once more. Jennings waits for it to drop before launching it into the Maidstone half.
Parkinson's switch of play has been a feature of this half, was a feature of Maidstone's play, certainly. And they've looked a threat down that side of Mills and Fisher.
And it was the said Parkinson, who was adjudged to have been fouled then.
I think he's given the ball away twice in the entire half, Parkinson. And he's been fouled on a couple of occasions. He's had a good first 45. Not convinced how much of a foul there is there, but he's got the free kick anyway.
He was with Conference Premier side Woking until joining Maidstone in 2013. Carrington breaks through the challenge. Bishop picks up the pieces. And Parkinson is back there again.
Carrington was a better pass there from Andy Bishop, just a safe pass at this stage of the game, keep the attack moving forward. Shot a risky ball, reverse ball into York.
Well, I think Kevin Wilkham was slightly concerned about the way that Wrexham had lost their momentum, having gone ahead, because they really did start in strong fashion.
They still haven't regained that that power and that intensity that they showed in the first 20.
Harris recalled tonight in the absence of Robbie Evans.
got to feel sorry for Robbie Evans. You know, got his chance in the first, he was doing really, really well, looking at a run in the team. It was a poor decision from the referee.
Well, I thought that was a foul, and then Smith goes in on Bodkin. And Manny Smith, goal scorer, is now going to be the first player booked in this game. I'm sure it'll be a yellow. They were shutting off the Maidstone fans. I think there was cover there. And Manny Smith is the first player booked. Barry Horn.
The Maidstone fans shouting for off in Holt with their own expectation. No way, that was a red card. Comes sliding across. He's never going to make contact with Bodkin, I don't think. He's missed the ball. I think the referee's got it right.
And Franny Collin, this appears to be in his range. 16 goals for Franny Collin this season. Six of them in the FA Cup, two against Stevenage to get them here. Will it be a shot? Everything is to his left. Three in the Wrexham wall. Collin takes it. That was neither a shot nor a cross, as it turns out. Long range effort by Mills is easily blocked, and Wrexham could counter here. Jennings has pace to burn. Just left the ball behind him. And there's that man, Parkinson, again. He really has been a shining light for Maidstone.
Not only has he covered the ground there, not only has he got the tackle in, he's made a good decision. He's not tried to do anything fancy. He's just put the ball out, allowing his teammates to get back into position. Good opportunity for a break there. Where's York? Over on the right-hand side. Joe Clark, with the initial turnover, couldn't quite get the pass out to him.
Here's White again. Piercing run by the young right-back. York crosses for Bishop. Can he turn Andy Bishop? No, he can't. Not the best ball back to Ashton. The Wrexham still have four in the middle, and a looping header from White. That would have been a collector's item, a goal for Ross White.
Well, not just the header there, the fact that he's in the penalty area, the run that got Wrexham to this position, and the pass to York was absolutely fantastic from the young right-back. York quickly reversed pass into the penalty area, it came out, and I think that was always going wide. I think Morgan again there is not quite sure where his post is.
Wrexham still hold the advantage, dying seconds of the first half. Clark once more, the captain. York is stopped by Simpson. 2 minutes of added time. We'll soon see the board go up.
Ten.
Jennings. Tried to thread it through for Ashton, who'd gone on the overlap. Simpson intervened.
Wrexham still got a good shape up, despite Neil Ashton being caught out of position there. Good covering, good shape at with the back three that was left.
Flatt, who's played his part in protecting Wrexham's clean sheet. Bishop tries to hassle Mills, but he does well. Carrington can't keep that in front of the Maidstone fans, under pressure from Jamie Coyle. It's important, Kevin Wilkin will think, that his side don't concede a sucker punch before half-time. More with Harris on the ball. Carrington. Harris delivers. Took a deflection. Fell for Joe Clark though. White is wide again. Harris is wide, sorry. And it's Tom Mills, the Glazer, who shields the ball. Just the dying seconds of injury time, Barry Horn. Yeah, well, still on a knife edge, isn't it? Even though Wrexham are leading.
Absolutely. Absolutely. 1-0. Good at half time. I'm sure that Kevin Wilkin will be happy with much of what Wrexham have done.
Bishop.
Clark was going for the glancing header. But for all of the chances that were created, especially in that early spell, first half of the first half, you know, they still had to rely on their goalkeeper to pull out two terrific saves to, first of all, not go behind, and then to keep them in the lead. Wrexham are continuing to hold the ball to see out the game to half-time. That is the half-time whistle from referee Scott Matheson. Wrexham hold the advantage thanks to that man, Manny Smith. His goal, his first of the season on 19 minutes. They'll be happy, will the Wrexham supporters. And what you have to also say is that Maidstone are not out of this yet. They will still feel this hope of a comeback. So let's go to pitch side and join Dylan Griffiths with the Wrexham manager, Kevin Wilkin.
Kevin, things going to plan?
By and large, yeah. As I said to you earlier, you know, if we keep our game nice and short and keep moving the ball on the deck, then hopefully more chances will come our way.
How crucial is the second goal then, Kevin?
Absolutely, you know, we need to put that bit of a cushion there between us and them. It's clearly, you know, one goal is never enough. Like I say, we need to keep moving the ball nice and short, nice and sharp, and if we can do that and create more chances, hopefully we can do that.
Kevin, thanks for your time.
Thank you.
So a real sense of anticipation among both sets of fans here this evening. The Maidstone boss watching on from the stands tonight. He saw his side come under pressure here as Carrington had a chance for Wrexham while saved. And then Wes York came close for the home team. But to Alex Fisher with a good chance for Maidstone there before relief for Wrexham. Manny Smith, good acrobatics there with the Wrexham goal. But Maidstone still in this game there, and Parkinson with a chance for the away side. So, gentlemen, not a bad first half here in the FA Cup.
Well, I've been really impressed with Wrexham. I think they've played really well, they've created loads of chances, and really this should be more than one goal ahead. But as we've seen so many times, Maidstone have had chances and they're still in the game and they've not put them to sleep yet. And I hope we don't come back and haunt them.
And that's the thing, Ewan, isn't it? They have plenty of possession, Wrexham, but Maidstone still in this.
Game should be dead and buried. The chances that Wrexham have created in that first half, I thought for the first 20-25 minutes they came out and they dominated the game, created chances, should be going in more than the one goal they've got, but they've got to keep it tight at the back. You know, they've looked vulnerable, especially with the counter-attack that Maidstone possess.
We saw those chances early on for York and Carrington, but they got the goal after about 19 minutes. Relief, obviously, for Wrexham, and Kevin Wilkin, here it comes.
Terrific goal as well. I mean, it doesn't do too much, not too much movement from Manny Smith, just sort of follows the ball in. Goalkeeper flaps at it, but what a finish that is. And I think if it doesn't go in, I think it's a penalty, because I think it's Sonny Miles that's picking him up and he's pulling him back. He's falling over, his balance is all over the shop, and that is a top finish from Manny Smith.
Great acrobatics, Dean, there. You'd have been proud to get on the end of that one there.
Yeah, I mean, if you have a look at the goalkeeper's part, he's played in that, he won't be very pleased with himself. I mean, it's just a simple ball into the box from a corner and he's flapped at it, never got off the ground. And when he scores the goal, he's actually about 5 yards out. But saying that, he's getting pulled back and he's took it really well and he's put his foot right through the ball, which has kept it underneath the crossbar.
But as we said, Ewan, so many chances before that goal went in.
That should have scored before then. I mean, the best one was for Mark Carrington. Should have scored when he was one-on-one with the goalkeeper. But yeah, you know, great ball in by Wes York. We've spoken about his quality. You know, a clever little header from Andy Bishop. He gets the second chance, but sort of snatches at it. And I just think, I mean, they get a bit of luck here. The ball rebounds into Carrington. It's on his left foot. That's the only excuse I'll give him. Should have finished it, though. I think this is Connor Jennings trying to be a bit too precise with his head. He's pulled off his defender, but this is Wes York. This is what he's about. He knows where the space is. He knows where he wants the ball. He does ever so well. He adjusts his body. And he's ever so unlucky. It's a terrific save by Morgan in the goal.
Yeah, Dean, good chance this, wasn't it? Another one here for Wrexham.
Yeah, well, he did, as I said, the keeper's made some great saves. But looking at the overall game, there's mismatches all over the pitch. Jay Harris and Joe Clark are too good for their midfield players. Wrexham's two strikers are too good for the centre-backs they're playing against. The two wide players are better than the full-backs they're playing against. So all over the pitch, Wrexham are just look a different class. So if I was Jay Saunders, I'd change the system and try and maybe put an extra man into the middle of the defence or an extra man into midfield and try and sort it out, because if it stays like this, I can see Wrexham scoring 3 or 4.
OK, let's go and find out what the Wrexham legend Mickey Thomas has made of the first half. He's with Dylan Griffiths.
Thanks, Ian. Yes, Mick here. It's been an entertaining first half.
Well, Wrexham played well. Should have been three or four goals up. Haven't took the opportunity. So Maidstone are still in this game for sure. They've had a couple of opportunities. They look a little bit... at the back four look disjointed at the time. Wrexham needs to expose that they can second half. But this game is not over yet at 1-0.
Wrexham need the second goal then?
Without doubt, yeah. Any cup side need the second goal. They won't give up. They've got nothing to lose. They'll give everything. But, you know, look, Wrexham looked far superior in that final third. They can get that other goal, I'll be happy with that.
And Mickey, happy memories also for you, the FA Cup, and that famous goal, it never goes away.
Well, I don't think people let it do. I love it anyway. Obviously, I scored that goal, but it wasn't just about me, about Wrexham team and the people that came to that game. Yeah, it was a great goal, but Steve Watkin, he gets the winner, never gets a mention. So, Steve, you're a hero.
And also, Mickey, it's been a sad week with the funeral of John Neil on Thursday, a former Wrexham and Chelsea manager, and a person you knew well.
Yeah, I'm honestly sad for me. I knew him so well. He started my life in football, gave me my life in football, and, you know, he took me to Chelsea, had a great time there. It's a sad loss, but it'll never be forgotten, you know, what he's done here at Middlesbrough, certainly at Chelsea. You know, he's a legend down there, and I'm lucky enough to play for a great man.
And finally, Mickey, what can we expect now in the second half?
Well, I expect Wrexham getting that third round draw. That's what I want. You know, it's not over, but if they get a second goal, it will be.
Mickey, thanks for your time. Enjoy the second half.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, I think if he had some commission for every time he spoke about that Arsenal goal in 1992, he'd be a very rich man, wouldn't he? But let's talk about the chances that Maidstone had in this first half, because they've had opportunities, haven't they?
Really good chances. The goalkeeper's made a couple of good saves, and they've missed a few. But they're a definite threat, and complacency can actually cost you games at this level. I mean, that's a great chance.
Yeah,
Ricochet goes the wrong way.
This one, it's the left-back, and Carrington hasn't gone with him. And it's Parkinson. I think he's just going to put his foot through that ball. He tried to place it. It's a good save by the goalkeeper, but what a chance that was. Me and Dean were talking, and Franny Collin with the header. That was a terrific chance.
He's come at him quick, but really, when that cross comes in, he's just got to get something on it, because the goalkeeper was past the near post. It's a goal if he touches it the right direction. But it's difficult when you're running that quick towards the ball.
So what's the cliche about 1-0 being a dangerous scoreline? I mean, they'll want to see the game out, Wrexham, as soon as possible, just to get that second goal.
Well, you've seen games where totally dominated first half by Wrexham, and then the complete opposite. So you never know, especially in the FA Cup. But they've had opportunities to score, so have Maidstone, but as I said, there's mismatches all over the pitch. And providing Wrexham keep moving the ball quickly, I think they'll score three or four goals.
You just wonder, Ewan, whether the superior fitness will tell in the second half for Wrexham.
It might do. I just look at Wrexham defensively. I look at both fullbacks. I think they've bombed on together at times. And I think you can't do that, otherwise you will get punished. They've got the one goal. You know, if they can't add another one and they keep a clean sheet, they go through. So it's all about concentration, not falling asleep defensively, and if they do that, they'll go through.
You spoke before the game, Dean, about these matches. They can be banana skins, and if you're in this position as the Wrexham manager, what are you saying to your players at half-time exactly? What's
well,
the message to them?
The big centre-back, he scored a great goal. Don't get sent off. He's already got a yellow card. In fact, I'd even think about taking him off, because if you go down to 10 men, I would be saying that's the only way we can get beat. Don't give a penalty away. Don't give the referee a chance to make a bad decision in our box. And make sure if you get the chance to put your foot through the ball in our box, just clear it. Don't take risks, because our two strikers are too good for their defence, and we'll score.
You're going to be nervous, aren't you, if you're the Wrexham manager? You're seeing it's 1-0, but the chances Maidstone have had.
The thing is, though, he will be. And yeah, he'll be delighted they've got the lead, but he'll be disappointed that it's not 2 or 3. You know, really, the game should have been put to bed in that first half with the chances that they've created. Yes, Maidstone have had a couple of chances of themselves. You know, young John Flatt's been outstanding. He's not had a lot to do, but what he has done, he's done extremely well. But they've got to be more ruthless in Maidstone's penalty box. You know, when you get those opportunities, especially when you're on top, like Wrexham have been for the majority of that half, you've got to take those chances.
OK, let's get the thoughts of Barry Horn in the commentary box with Rob Phillips.
Yeah, Barry, you heard what the lads say, that they think it could be 3 or 4 to Wrexham, but they may pay for not taking those chances.
Well, I mean, that's what we've been saying throughout that first 45 minutes, really. Great start. But there's absolutely no doubt that, you know, Maidstone are very much in this game. At 1-0, you know, they've already had two great chances, two great saves. you know, the next one might go in and then it's panic stations and who knows what might happen. So everything that the lads have said, you can't disagree with. Wrexham, you know, need to keep it tight. But for me, if they don't change anything, if they just keep going forward, if they just keep going for that second goal, play with the same intensity and positive attitude that they started the game with, that's for me is the best way to go about this second half.
And if you're Jay Saunders, what are you saying to Maidstone at half-time?
Well, I wouldn't change too much. If they, you know, Dean was suggesting that they might want to throw an extra man in their midfielder at the back, they've got to score a goal. You know, so 2-0, 3-0, it doesn't really matter in the FA Cup, does it? You might as well go out fighting and having a go for it. They've got to score a goal, and the way that they're playing now on the counter, at Pags in the midfield, I thought, had a really, really good half there, set them up there from that right-hand side of midfield. So I think both teams, I'd be surprised if either team changed too much, to be honest.
I can't believe how you're not cold and I'm wrapped up for the winter. Maybe
I'm
weak.
You're a southern softie, Rob, aren't you?
Well, let's join two men of the north, one from the very north of Great Britain, and Dylan Griff is our reporter. He's speaking to the Wrexham chief executive, Don Burcham.
Yes, thanks, Rob, and I've got the scarf. Don Burcham hasn't got the scarf on, but Don, first of all, how are the nerves?
Yeah, they're holding out. I thought we started really well. Had a lot of possession, attacked well. They came into it towards the end of the first half, but yeah, we're pretty calm. We're okay.
Big second half ahead.
Oh, absolutely. I think they'll come at us and give us a game. But yeah, it's a great cup tie, great atmosphere. Good day.
And financially, Don, how important is it for Wrexham to get through to the third round?
Well, we take a step at a time. We'll try to get through this one. But yeah, it'd be wonderful. I mean, it all depends on who we get. But a Premiership club, 40, 50,000 fans, half the gate would be most welcome, yeah.
Can you enjoy the second half? An early second goal would do the trick, wouldn't it?
No, the day you become chief executive, you stop enjoying football, that's for sure.
Don, thanks for joining us, and Dallas, hope you enjoy the second half.
Pleasure, thank you.
There we go. Well, we're certainly cold stood here on the cop stand as the substitutes go through their routines at half-time. Dean, I just wonder, how could Maidstone get back into this game in the second half? If you're their manager, what will you be saying? What will Jay Saunders be telling his team?
Well, both teams are playing 4-4-2, and Maidstone have got two strikers, and sometimes you think playing with two strikers is the way to score a goal, but if you can't get the ball off Wrexham's midfield, then you've got two strikers waiting for a ball that never comes. So sometimes you're better off putting another man into midfield so you dominate a bit more possession, and maybe you can get players joining in a bit more up front. So I would, if I was Jay Saunders, I would put another man into the middle of midfield, because Jay Harris and Joe Clark are too good for their two midfield players. And you get an advantage that way, and maybe creep up the pitch. Also, it makes you a bit more solid, so you don't concede another goal. So it might be in the last 15 minutes, then you can go for it.
Would you have expected to see a bit more from Franny Collin there, danger man, Ewan?
Yeah, he's been quiet. He does thrive on chances. He's not really one to get involved in build-up, holding the ball up. He's got a good understanding with May, his partner up front. But chances have been few and far between for Franny to show what quality that he's got. I mean, the one that he had, the header, he'll be bitterly disappointed that he didn't hit the target. Too much on it. Yeah, he only needed a glancing header. And as Dean said, the goalkeeper's out of the equation and Mason are back in it. I think it's a tough one for their manager, because you don't want to throw too many men forward at the start of this second half. You're not going to look for that goal that will bring you back on level terms, because I think if they do that, I think Wrexham will open them up all day long with the pace of Connor Jennings and Wes York.
OK, well, the second half coming up, plenty more live sport coming up on BBC Wales as well. There's live commentary at Swansea City away to West Ham tomorrow on BBC Radio Wales and Radio Cymru in the Swansea area. Coverage starts at 1 o'clock. Monday night, live on Radio Wales from 7, it's the Wales Sports Awards, including the biggie, the result of the BBC Wales Sports Personality of the Year, also streamed live on the BBC Sport Wales website and the red button from 10. And on Friday, it's at Sport Wales at 7 o'clock on BBC Two Wales, the last one in the series before the Christmas break. So, gentlemen, how do you see the second half going then? Would you expect, as we suggested, Wrexham's extra fitness to tell and them to go on and get the second, third goals maybe? Or can you see Maidstone coming back into it?
You never know, but we're not allowed to bet, but if I was going to have a bet, Jay Harris and Joe Clark have got another gear in them. I signed the both of them, and the both of them are strolling through this game. They've got another gear. If they need to step up a gear, they can.
Wrexham's two strikers look really good partnership, and they've got too much for that defence. So if the game keeps going as it is, I can see Wrexham just scoring two or three goals. So their manager, for me, has to do something before it happens.
You would? I think they've got too much quality. As Dean said, you know, Harris and Clark in that middle, they've got great passing range. The movement of the forwards, I think Wrexham, they've just got too much for Maidstone. But as it's only 1-0, okay, you've got to keep them tight at the back.
OK, there we go. So, will the second half prove to be as entertaining as the first? Can Wrexham see out this game? So let's rejoin our commentary team for the second half. Barry Horn and Rob Phillips.
There's Manny Smith. And there's Jonathan Flatt, who was instrumental in ensuring that Maidstone didn't get a goal first half. Wrexham have a lead as they play for that third round place and maybe a draw against a Premier League side on Monday night. Changes at half time. Matt Plodkin, who actually made his debut for Gillingham in the FA Cup, and he was taken off just after the hour. Matt Plodkin and replaced by one Ewan Roberts. Whatever happened to him? So Maidstone look for an early reply. The pride of the Ryman Premier League taking on Wrexham of the Vanarama Conference. In the amber and black, not too much black on the shirt, and Wrexham in their red and black boots, with an early throw for Ross White. Bishop made himself available. Kevin Wilkin really pleased with Ross White, not sure yet whether he's a centre half or a right back, but that's maybe why he's more of a centre-half, Barry Hall.
That's a bit harsh, Rob. I think, to be honest, he's done really well tonight. Again, Ross White got him down the pitch well. His passing's been OK. Put a couple of good balls in the first half. That one was always a bit difficult. He couldn't quite wrap his foot around it to bring it to keep it on the pitch.
So there's Kevin Wilkin. Let's find out what the Maidstone manager, Jay Saunders, we will speak to him, I'm sure, a little bit later. There's Jay Saunders. Touched in the director's box. Heard about a touchline ban yesterday. Talk about bad timing. Watching his side, though, threaten again with Mills, the left-back forward.
Almost inevitably, it's a ball from central midfield to the right-hand side. Flish is involved. And so is Mills. Those two have been a threat down the left-hand side, both from the club's academy.
Yeah, he's a glazer and a window fitter. No danger to windows there with that shot, though it was a little high. That was Bishop's hand was caught Sonny Miles there. It's really difficult to tell in those circumstances just what happened, but
absolutely no intent whatsoever. Nothing wrong with that from Andy Bishop whatsoever, and minimal contact, I would suggest, between the centre forward and the centre back.
There's Sonny Miles, he's a building site manager, and the day after the Stevenage game, he had to be at work at 5 a.m. Stevenage replay.
Did he make it?
He did, yes.
Straight to work, was it?
He did. It's a bit like that, I suspect, yeah. And he's taking the easy way out there, back to Worgan. Worgan and Flatt have both covered themselves in plenty of glory, the two goalkeepers, in what's been an entertaining tie. Both sides going for it, as you'd hope. Jennings sends York in pursuit. York is very quick. Where's Lee York? Clark is in support.
York's got the beating of both centre-backs. I thought there he was just going to knock it into his own path and go for goal. Cut across the centre-back. I think he's then got to either let you go or he's got to foul you. Instead, he checked out.
It's opened up for Harris. What a lovely ball into Bishop. Chance here for Andy Bishop. And he's missed. My word. Andy Bishop. Well, it's normally meat and drink, isn't it?
That was a fantastic move and it would have been an absolutely sensational goal. Jay Harris gets on the ball. He's got an option to his left. He goes for the more difficult option to his right. Plays in Andy Bishop, who's timed his run perfectly. That's a really clever ball with the outside of his foot. Brilliant. Bishop's free, and he's done the right thing. He's gone to lift it over the keeper. He knows he's going to be coming to spread himself. He just can't keep it underneath the crossbar.
Andy Bishop.
Fantastic play from Harris.
It was. It was a beautiful ball forward, wasn't it? White has had to race back to stop that gun up for a corner.
The thing about that pass, it completely took the defence out, but the weight on it and the angle of it made it easy for Andy Bishop, but also drew the keeper out as well. You know, just took everybody out of the equation.
Now we'll see if Alex Flischer has a long throw. He's taking four or five paces before launching this into the Wrexham penalty area. Plenty of Maidstone shirts for us. Hit the bar. It was Jamie Coyle. And it's still not clear. And two shots for handball. Oh, no, it was it Jack Parkinson? He's holding his head. And that was so close, with flat beaten.
Basic stuff. Long throw in. It was always going to be a long throw from the preparation, the fact that they've loaded the penalty area. It was a good one, good, flat, a lot of pace on it. And flat was beating all ends up.
Been fired up by Jay Saunders at half-time. Flat takes no chances, punches away. York holds off his man for Jennings to clear for Wrexham. He's got nowhere to go and he's caught in possession. Good defensive work. And then he gets out of it nicely, Connor Jennings. Ashton.
Well, they're giving it a proper go at the moment, aren't they, mates?
Oh, Tom Mills really put himself around on that touchline then.
As well as... Yes, they are tackling back well. Yes, they're expending a lot of energy. They're also leaving themselves very open. You know, there was two occasions there, Wrexham had the opportunity, if they'd wanted to launch a counter-attack. The space between the front players and the back players was massive. The midfield players had committed, the full-back was committed. You know, I suspect that's going to be the pattern of the game if Maidstone do have good possession. And they've got to throw men forward, but you see Wrexham there. You know, they've got the pace to break, and as the game goes on, the fitness and Wrexham's extra pace could tell if, of course, at the moment it's quite a big if Maidstone don't score.
Well, Wrexham have been warned, and that man Parkinson went ever so close to levelling the scores. Flat was beaten almost for the first time this afternoon. Carrington went down under the challenge of Flischer, but Wrexham are allowed to play on with Harris. He runs into traffic, but he beautifully moves out of the way. Bishop into the box. Was Harris caught after the ball had been played? He's furiously complaining to the referee, Jay Harris.
Clever play by Harris. He had to wait. He wanted to play the ball through there. Oh, earlier than that, actually, Bishop, I think, had ran offside. And then when he does play him in, it's a good idea from Andy Bishop. The referee played advantage there. That was a good advantage because Wrexham were on the charge there. The ball in from Bishop just didn't come round, did it? He caught it too square, flew out for a goal kick.
I think Jay Harris thought Jamie Coyle had impeded him as he tried to break through there.
I think you understand how the referee might have missed that.
Yeah.
With his eyes inevitably going to be drawn to the ball, but maybe his assistant might have seen it.
Clark looks for the run of York, they're in behind again, chance at York! Bishop! Well, why did he cross? Why didn't he shoot Barry Horn?
Well, that sort of sums up, where's York? This evening, he's had three or four opportunities to get the ball out of his feet in front of him and go for goal. Here, he's got a chance to shoot on goal and he wants to pass it. You know, just put your foot through that far post. If the keeper stops it, Bishop's there to tap in the rebound. Fantastic ball again from Joe Clark. I think that's three times he's looked for Wes York and put him in over the top from deep positions.
Whatever happens, Barry Horn, you can see, and you're an FA Cup winner yourself, but the desire of both these sides.
It's been a cracking game. I mean, you know, if
who said the FA Cup had lost this luster?
That's about what I was going to say. I think we all think of the FA Cup as being, you know, Premier League teams playing, putting reserve teams out. You know, Wrexham have come into this. This is their third game. Maidstone, I think this is their fifth game. And each time you go into it, it's a big occasion. It's a big game. And one of these teams will be looking forward to Monday, like, you know, like it's Christmas. Come early.
Yep, 7 o'clock on Monday night is the draw. Just to remind you that it's on BBC Two. And Wrexham or Maidstone will be number 47. Bishop. He's beaten to it by Miles. Quite literally Miles, but Sonny Miles. It's Ashton to Jennings now. Wrexham looking for the goal, which they hope will kill off Maidstone. They're in behind again. But Carrington was coming in.
Needed to be cut back another couple of yards now. Carrington held his role really well.
Maidstone are in here. That's a lovely ball forward by May. And there are Wrexham players streaming back. And it's still not clear. Bodkin thinks about shooting. Well, it's astonishing stuff, this. It's just attack against attack. Neither side worried about too much. I think it was Franny Collin who got in behind.
Well, we've gone from another fantastic ball inside the fullback at one end. Within seconds, John Flatt is keeping Wrexham in the game, well, keeping preserving Wrexham's lead yet again. And that was way, way, way too easy. It's a nice play, three little passes, one touch. And that's a fantastic recovering run from Joe Clark, just to put a bit of pressure on the striker there. But at the end of it all, it's another terrific save. Fantastic save.
Well, it's brilliant entertainment, and this time York is in behind for Carrington. Oh, he's pushed over. Is that going to be a penalty? And I wonder whether Simpson is going for this. Aaron Simpson waits. It's a red card for the teenager, Aaron Simpson. Wes York was in behind just once too often, and Simpson just brought him down.
Well, it's a shame, real shame for Aaron Simpson. It's a shame for the game, and it's a shame for Maidstone, but Scott Matteson, no choice here. Wes York is in. He cuts across his man, which I said he should have done earlier. There's contact, there's clear contact there. It's all over him, the knee, the hip, the elbow. Wes York, I don't think, he's not made a meal of that. He's last man by some distance.
Aaron Simpson makes the long march. He has to walk past the dugouts and down to the tunnel as Andy Bishop looks to put Wrexham further ahead. Scored against Woking in round one. Andy Bishop to make it just a little more comfortable for Wrexham. Walden went the right way, but Bishop's pace beat him. And you can see the delight of Jonathan Flatt and the Wrexham players. And Lee Walden, for all his heroics, is beaten from the spot. And it's an uphill task now for the 10-man Maidstone.
That's game over, or at least absolutely 100% should be. And what a crazy, crazy, it's probably 2 minutes. Wrexham in at one end of the chance. Maidstone in at the other. Great save from Flatt within 30 seconds. Penalty at the other end, and by the way, that is a quality penalty. Grazing the inside of the post, on the floor. Good pace on it, accuracy, pace. Walking the night he's having, you wouldn't be surprised if he pulled off a save there. But even on the night that he's having tonight, couldn't get anything on it. So that will be a massive, massive sigh of relief for Kevin Wilkin, because Maidstone could so easily have been all square within a minute. I'm guessing, I don't know what it said on the clock, but it felt like a few seconds. Wes York in on goal, and that rule has to be changed, by the way. The penalties,
this is Bodkin.
just will not give up, this side. And there's movement on the Maidstone bench. Down to 10 men. And I think it'll be Matt Bodkin to pay the price for that red card, I wonder. Aaron Simpson already has, but they're contemplating a change. Ah, Maidstone.
He's going to, I think Jason's going to try and keep a back four intact. He's going to bring somebody on to play it right back.
Jay Simpson directing operations from the grandstand. His phone bill will be something tonight. 10 men, how will they react to that? 2-0 down against a side 30-odd places above them in the pyramid, with a prospect of an FA Cup third round tie in Monday's draw. Oh, it's not Bodkin, I gather it's Jay May who's coming off. Harris is now, we're about to see, it's Richard Davis who's coming on for Maidstone.
That's a sensible change. Take off Jimmy. He's not been involved in the game too much. Had that something of an injury worry halfway through the first half. Hasn't really contributed. And Davis is going to right back, and they'll play four at the back, and then let's see what they do up front. Maybe going to ask a lot of the two wide midfielders to get up and down to join in with Franny Collin. That's a long way back for them now, isn't it?
Well, Richard Davis has gone on to the left wing. He's got two goals this season. Onto the right back position for Maidstone. And he'll go there for Simpson. It looks like Franny Collin will have to maybe plough a long furrow, although at the moment Alex Fisher is probably the speediest of the Maidstone players. He's the furthest forward, so just past the hour mark, Barry Horn. It should be Wrexham's game now, shouldn't it?
You just sit back, enjoy the ride, and watch Wrexham close this game out. That's what should happen.
But this is the
FA Cup. That's what should happen. And I have to say, I was just about to say that they've got to change that rule. You know, Wes York may or may not have gone on to score there. The penalty puts Wrexham or any team back in the position that they were in, and it's potentially, you know, so often it ruins the game when the man gets sent off as well.
This is Collin into Bodkin, knocks it past Hudson. Keep it in? No, I don't think he did. Matt Bodkin. Jonathan Flatt beaten by a Parkinson header, but the woodwork came to his rescue, and it's made it, well, bleak for them at the moment, but such has been their journey. There's plenty of spirit left in them. Remember, this is a side relegated seven divisions. They restarted in 1992. They got men forward here. Picked up by Mills. Mills wide to the substitute Davis. Davis looks for Collin. Breaks to Rogers. Rogers, who's wriggled away from Harris. Rogers again on the outside. Good cross in. It's Fisher. Alex Fisher was on hand, and I told you this Maidstone side would not lie down, and they're back in this, the 10 men.
Well, all credit to them. They've been bold, they've been determined, they've not been they've not taken that and allowed themselves to be beaten up by it. Lovely little ball inside there, inside Carrington. Bit of footwork there, and at this point I thought he'd gone too wide on his left foot. He just wraps his foot round it, It's a perfect cross, and any one of those players rushing back towards John Flatt's goal might have put that in.
Colin was there waiting too. Blaine Hudson was facing his own goal, but that will be claimed by Alex Fisher, his 15th goal of the season, and a goal which puts this game, well, at least closer, back in the balance, you might say. York tries to go beyond the Maidstone defence again.
Well, that will give that. I mean, a goal is great any time, but to get that goal so soon after they've lost the mark and gone 2-0 down really will give Maidstone an enormous lift. That'll give them self-belief. You know, if they'd gone 10, 15 minutes without a goal, the self-belief would start to drift. But now they will believe they can get another one. It's up to Wrexham now to just calm things down, keep the ball, kill this game off. Maidstone, you know, the man down, don't forget. Get them running around, tire them out, wear them out, sicken them with possession.
They're losing and they're a man down, but he must be so proud of his side, Jay Saunders. Carrington, good challenge by Hills. It really is opening up. Bodkin looks at the run of Fisher. Hudson bundled him over.
I don't think there's anything wrong with Blaine Hudson's contact there. That's just a coming together. I think Fisher's waited for him and he's taken the opportunity to go down. I don't think he fancied himself one-on-one against Hudson. He's ready to go down there. He's left a little bit on Blaine Hudson as he went down as well.
Well, the 10 but men ten half their team in and around the penalty area.
I was going to say 10 men or 11 men. You get a free kick in this position, you've got a chance.
So it's Colin who'll take it, the top scorer. Gets it past the wall. Cleared away by Carrington. Fisher could take a long throw, but it's taken quickly by Sonny Miles. Launched into the box by Mills. Only half cleared by Wrexham. Mills keeps the pressure on. Little touch by Rogers. Fisher's in there again. Manny Smith got there in the nick of time.
Well, Wrexham went a man down on Saturday, or Tuesday, sorry, against Bristol Rovers. And you would never have known it. I think it was the best part of 45 minutes. You would never have known that one of the teams had 10 men, the way the game panned out. So, you know, the Wrexham lads should have that in their mind, that, you know, what they did to Bristol Rovers with 10 men, and not let Maidstone that there's the possession. I mean, they're having a terrific, terrific second half, aren't they? Look at that, everything, 55-45, five attempts, 3-2 on target to one, so stats are there. Despite being in front at the moment, Maidstone are giving it a proper go here.
What a game. Terrific stuff. This is what the FA Cup is all about. Never say die attitude. And of course, for these two clubs, as Flatt comes to the rescue for Wrexham, for these two clubs, the financial consequences of reaching round three and getting a big draw.
Listen, you know, I don't think anybody in either camp would want to talk about it, so just talk generally for either club, whichever club goes through. First of all, is you're in the FA Cup third round, which at the start of the season is your FA Cup final, if you like. And then, of course, the consequences of that are possibly, you know, big. The rewards, prize money, gate money is great, but you draw a plum tie and that can make a big, big difference to your club. Seen something.
Saw it.
Yeah.
That's a fan certainly saw it. Oh, a stick. And White made sure that there was going to be no advantage from that mistake. Now, what will the referee do?
Well, that's interesting, that, because I'm not quite sure what that gesture from the referee was, when he was quite deliberately and, you know, pointing at Jay Harris. Say, I've seen that.
He fooled us, didn't he?
I've seen that. I'll come back to deal with it. But quite clearly, he's either not seen it, or what he's seen doesn't merit any action. I thought he might have used the yellow card for the for a foul on the Maidstone lad as well a few seconds later.
James Rogers gets the decision against Andy Bishop there.
I think Bishop's being fouled there, isn't he?
This game is not over. What a display by the 10 men from Kent. Mills can't reach the penalty over the free kick. Harris tries to pull this through two challenges. Well, that's a good advantage played by the referee on that occasion. Carrington will get it back.
Two missed
from Jennings.
Two missed opportunities there from Wrexham's point of view.
Clark is loping forward. Carrington into the box. Chance here on the far post. Well, it's Jennings taken an awful long time. Bishop can't thread it towards goal. Bodkin clears away.
It's almost too easy at times. In that move there, Carrington's ball to Conor Jennings. Just needs to be in front of him, and he's away. And then Jennings gets the ball in control. Where's York? He's in. Just roll it behind the back four, and he's in.
Just over 20 minutes to go. It's a proper cup tie on our hands here. York into the box again. And that time, no mistake from Tom Mills with a challenge.
Terrific tackle from Tom Mills. I mean, there's not many players that can live with Wes York's pace, but he's having a good go, isn't he? He's recovered brilliantly there. Timed that tackle to perfection.
He's done well, hasn't he, Tom Mills, tonight? Going forward and in defence.
22 years old. Comes from the academy, I think.
Well, he's a glazer. Is this his window of opportunity to impress?
Come on now, Rob. Stop it.
Corner to Wrexham. The first of this second half. Smith is there again. It can't get it through this time. Hudson's chance is blocked as well. Still not cleared. Somehow it was pinball in there.
What a block by the substitute Richard Davis as Bishop wound that one up.
Good ball by White. Jennings pulls away. Will he keep this in? He does keep it in.
Good corner. But Manny Smith met that really, really well. The delivery from Ashton was good. Smith met it. Good power. And it's a block. And then this is a fantastic block from the substitute. Bishop looks just... Oh, it's actually playing Hudson, so he looks to just finish that off.
It's really good defensive work. By the 10 men, Aaron Simpson sent off as Wrexham had a penalty. But they're still in there fighting, given hope by Fisher. Morgan clears. That's Fisher, the goal scorer. Breaks for Rogers, lofts it forward for Colin. Not seen too much of him. Good head back by Hudson.
It's easy to get them wrong. And the ball's coming down on top of you. You're not quite sure where you are. And then looking to find out where your goalkeeper is, you don't get the contact on the ball that you need. Good concentration there from Hudson.
So don't forget tomorrow on BBC Radio Wales, Radio Cymru from 1 o'clock, West Ham United against Swansea live from the Bowling Ground. And on Monday night, the Wales Sport Awards. Red button on BBC Sport Wales website. And Sport Wales next Friday, 7 o'clock on BBC Two Wales. Full preview of the weekend action. Previewed last night, and this game has not disappointed. Bishop trying to kill off Maidstone again. Just over.
Nice play from Joe Clark. Nice feed into Bishop's feet. And then they had options to centre forward. Could have gone back. Good running from midfield to support him. He's decided to go it alone. Just rising shot over the bar, but worryingly from Maidstone's point of view there, how easily Clark was able to find Bishop. A simple straight ball into his feet.
Kevin Wilkin knows this game is not won yet. Carrington robbed by Rogers. Parkinson knows how to get his side going forward. This time it was picked up by Ashton. Now White, plenty of space. You feel that the spaces will be down the flanks against 10 men.
Well, later they're playing the game in such a way that the space is likely to occur anywhere on the pitch because they are committing men forward.
But Jennings has found space wide. Chance here for York! Wide!
And there's a case in point. I mean, where's York finding space where no striker should ever find space? A couple of yards from the penalty spot. Good cut back. decent first touch from York, put the ball more or less where he wanted it to be. Actually, he's got a bit lucky with the bounce, but just dragged it past the left hand, the keeper's left hand post. It's another chance goes begging.
Where's York won the penalty, but he'll wonder why he hasn't scored tonight. He's had his chances. He's been the man getting behind this Maidstone defence more than anyone else. Jennings plays a little deeper.
He's been found well as well, you have to say. Clark's found him two, three times.
A lovely touch by Colin to Bodkin, though. Fisher's up ahead. Bodkin goes by himself into the penalty area. Has two in the box. Rogers looks for Colin. Beaten to it. So is Harris. Bricks on Rogers again. Oh! That would have been a stunner from Jamie Rogers. That must have been inches. Nah, Barry Horn.
I think that was comfortably going wide, to be honest with you. No, it wasn't that far, was it?
You're so cool if that's comfortable.
No wonder John Flats has gone for it. I thought that was one for the cameras, to be honest, but no, that wasn't far away. And actually, it didn't come round, did it? It sort of straightened up. And so it might very well have curled in that stuff. But I think Flat would have been there. I think he had it covered, had it curled in on that left-hand post.
Louis Malt is warming up for Wrexham. And Maidstone are about to make a substitution too. Second by Jay Saunders, by phone to his number two, Nicky Southall. Louis Malt, the Wrexham top scorer, which is handy to have.
I was going to say, actually, I mean, you know, Kevin Wilkins' bench looks quite healthy, doesn't it?
Optimistic by Jennings.
Elliot Durrell, Johnny Hunt, Dean Keats is coming back to fitness. Robbie Evans out suspended tonight, so the squad's looking quite good.
So Mark Lovell comes on for the Maidstone top scorer, Franny Collin, which is slightly surprising. And Wesley York's evening is over. He won the penalty. He'll feel slightly frustrated that he's not been on the score sheet himself. And Wrexham can bring on their top scorer, Louis Malt. Doesn't look happy about coming off, but I'd like to see that in players.
I think he'll be fans. Well, two things really. Firstly, you know, he can be pleased with his work rate, the fact that he's got into good positions. He's earned that penalty when he looked like he would score himself. The other side of it, he personally would probably be a little bit disappointed. He hasn't got his name on the score sheet, but he's got his team into a winning position.
With that penalty, which Andy Bishop tucked away after Manny Smith put Wrexham ahead in the first half. But Maidstone, what an effort. I think the greatest tribute you can pay to them is that you would not know, unless you saw that little red card on the screen in the top left-hand corner, you would not know that they were down to 10 men. And here they come again, and that header was into the hands of Flat.
It's another chance.
Well, that good was ball level.
In. Good ball in, substitute just on. And again, three men in the penalty area trying to get on the end of that cross. You cannot help but admire their effort and their desire to get back in this game.
Dodkin's been a real threat. May have been Jamie Rogers. It was Rogers headed on. Mark Lovell, of course, Barry Horn. I think he played with his dad, Steve.
Yeah, many moons ago. Yeah.
And last throw of the dice from Jay Saunders. He's about to make another substitution as well. And Bodkin, who was replaced by our very own Ewan Roberts on his FA Cup debut for Gillingham, makes way tonight for Alex Brown. He's also got two goals, Alex Brown.
Well, I can only think that Alex Bodkin's gone off there because he's ran himself into the ground, because he has put in a shift over on that far right-hand side. And Smith just caught there.
Smith is caught by the substitute, Alex Brown. talking about making an impression with your first touch. It's pretty tough though.
Well, 6-1 after
actually,
the other.
I'm not sure he did a lot wrong then.
Ronnie Smith certainly not shirking that one.
Look at those stats.
39 attempts on goal. That says it all about how exciting and how alternate this game's been.
And Bishop wins the free kick at Sonny Miles' expense. So 2-1. We've said this before, but another goal will surely see off Maidstone for Wrexham, but I hesitate to say that. Louis Malt is there.
They're leaving two men up from this free kick, down to 10 men.
Nothing to lose now, though, have they? Carrington steps over it. Malt hits it. Just off target. There he is, Louis Malt, 10 goals this season. And was with Jay Saunders, hasn't given up hope on this one yet. Inside the last 10 minutes, side down to 10 men, but they're still in there battling. Better than that. Need field Barry Horn, the next goal either wins it for Wrexham or means we go to the Gallagher Stadium on December the 16th.
Well, I'm not going to make the last 10 minutes or last 10 minutes plus. I'm definitely not going to get drawn into making any predictions because the way this game's been, who knows? Who knows? 39 attempts on goal. Not surprising. I think you'd probably have to say that both goalkeepers are contenders for man of the match. You suspect there's going to be a couple of chances at least between now and the end of the game. Certainly. Wrexham will not fancy a trip to Maidstone if that is the outcome of the 90 minutes here.
And it's on a 3G pitch.
Well, that's what I meant. Not just the fact that it's miles away.
See, the pitch tonight has played okay. A lot of rain. And slide in early on, but
a lot of rain up here today. Yeah. And yesterday,
Carrington. You really have to hold it up. They're leading 2-1. Ross White wants more than that, though. I thought Malt was going to try and shoot. Well, actually, White was caught after the ball had gone.
So a good run from White. A nice ball out to Louis Malt. And you're right, striker in his form. I was expecting him to take that on himself, but unselfishly, he's just tried to play Bishop in. Referee bringing play back. The other thing as well, of course, here, that, you know, these final few minutes, you'd expect Wrexham to finish stronger than the part-timers. In particular, they've been down to 10 men for quite some time, so you would expect now the home team to just to try and see this game out.
Does Neil Ashton get a look at this, or will Louis Malt? No, it looks as if Malt is walking away.
Well, it's set up for a left footer.
Ashton, it is. Trying to go under the wall, and the wall stood firm. Oh, that was a total mishit. White makes a mistake and presents possession, and Parkinson looks to play a teasing ball forward. Smith was under it, Carrington is back there.
He's done that well all night, Parkinson. As soon as he gets the ball, he's thinking about getting the ball forward. And his pass selection's been good. He underhit that one. Didn't quite get over the top of Smith, but he's had a good game in the midfielder.
He has, but they've had plenty of players who done their reputations no harm at all. And the Ryman Premier League. Would have to get into the Conference South before making the same division as Wrexham. 30-odd places between the two sides. Man difference here tonight as well, but you wouldn't know it, although runs away from Mark Lovell.
Good space to run into then. Wrexham giving the ball away and leaving themselves short at the back as well. Ronnie Smith was on his way to cover, and you'd fancy him against Lovell, but another anxious moment.
Lovell wins the header in midfield against the diminutive Jay Harris. Rogers turns through three Wrexham players. He's in the substitute, Davis. He's looking for the angled run of Alex Brown, playing just in behind the front two. Parkinson does pick out Brown. Lays it back for Rogers. Harris got there. Oh, there's a bit of afters on the deck between Rogers and Harris. Nothing too serious, I don't think. The referee was right there in the nick of time.
Well, I think the referee's done really well tonight. Because on another day, a different referee, we might have been three, four, five more yellow cards.
He's going to take action here, though, against Mark Lovell for the challenge on Manny Smith. Lovell gets the yellow card. Joins Smith in the book, actually.
It's the battering ram approach. But yeah, just to go back to the referee, I think he's been very sensible. He's played a lot of good advantages for both teams. Could have got a few more yellow cards. We've seen some stupid sendings off the race course in the last few games. But he's been very sensible tonight.
So Wrexham make the change. James Pearson, who's on loan from Leicester City, is coming on for Ross White, who has done really well at right back. Pearson, you may see the resemblance with the Leicester manager Nigel Pearson. That's his dad. Didn't want him to play on Tuesday against Bristol Rovers, but they've allowed him to pick up an FA Cup appearance here for the last 5 minutes or so.
Malt. He's still recovering from a slight strain.
That was impressive by Hudson, because if he hadn't got that ball, Wrexham might have been in a few problems. Fisher was in behind. Is there a sting in the tail for Maidstone United? Harris.
Space over on the left hand side, Jennings and Ashton.
Jennings goes the other way, cuts back inside, may fancy a prop. Instead, brings in Pearson, the substitute. His cross is a delicate one, and that's it! Beautiful header up the near post by Andy Bishop, and that surely puts Wrexham into the third round draw. Bishop gets a double, it's Wrexham 3, Maidstone United 1.
That surely settles it. Just opened up for Wrexham down both sides of the pitch. Jennings and Ashton on the overlap. He came across infield, played the right fullback in just on the pitch, and he's put a ball into the near post area. That's begging to be attacked. Bishop does just that. The Mason defenders all switch off. They think that Morgan's going to come for that. They just assume that that's the goalkeeper's ball. Bishop doesn't. He gets across the front of the keeper. A great centre forwards goal.
Well, he's 32, he played more than 230 times for Bury, but you don't lose that instinct to attack the right areas if you're a striker.
There's a whole combination of things, the ball in, and then the goalkeeper for once hasn't been... Well, actually, his shot stopping has been brilliant. Maybe his work on crosses hasn't actually been that good if you think about the first goal, but Bishop's gone for it. He's picked up the line of the cross, he's attacked it, and he's got across the front of the keeper. A really, really good header, really good run. And that is game over.
Here comes Clark. This is into the box.
The most noticeable thing about that was just how open the pitch was when Wrexham turned the possession over. Maidstone tiring, gaps appearing all over the place. Wrexham could have gone down either flank and got across into the box there.
So, in your guise as a director of Wrexham, who do you want in the third round draw, Barry Horn?
This is which chance. Pearce, another decent ball in. Do you know what? I'm being deadly serious. I would not allow myself to think about it. I'll have a think about it now because I'm pretty confident that we're going to see this one through. But, well, being a bit selfish.
Do you want a Premier League side here or would you rather go away to a Premier League side? Say, for instance, and your chief executive, Dom Burcham, threw this to me before the game. How about Manchester United away?
I know Dom Burcham just wants a glass of red wine with Sir Alex. I think that's where he's coming from. You know what? I wouldn't mind another one of the non-league clubs here at home and go to the next round. But failing that, how about Everton?
Split loyalties with Everton, FA Cup winner with that.
Totally selfish on that one. No, seriously, whatever comes.
Jonathan Flatt collects. And we're approaching the last minute, Barry. I'll be asking you for your man of the match in a minute or so.
Well,
Give you a bit of time to think about it.
There's been some good performances on both teams. I think the man of the match should come from the winning team. And it looks like Wrexham are going to be the winning team. So, John Flatt, not for, you know, a consistent... You know, he's not been worked consistently out of the 90 minutes. Morgan's probably had more to do, but he's made crucial saves at crucial times. So, for that, probably... I'm just having a think, looking at the scan. Joe Clark's done well.
Yeah, you've got a bit of time to decide. Yeah. 4 minutes of added time as the ball puts into the box again is collected by Morgan. As Jonathan Flatt, who's one of the contenders, we've heard Barry Horn talk about Joe Clark as well.
Manny Smith's been immaculate again, but you just come to take that for granted this season. He just gets on with it, right place, right time. He's got his goal as well.
And 4 minutes of added time. There's another Wrexham sub about to come on. There's Wrexham hold possession. And only now you would feel that Maidstone believe this game is out of their reach.
Yeah, it's amazing how quickly the legs become very, very tired. 2-1, they're still full of energy. Third goal, and then that just is very, very quickly sapped.
So Ashton, who of course played at Brighton last time they're in the third round. Malt shoots and Morgan collects. Morgan still thinks there may be a goal in it, another goal in it for Maidstone, so does Mark Lovell. That's referee Scott Matheson. Reckons there's a foul. So, Barry, your man of the match.
Well, I'd give it John Flatt. As I say, he might not have been the busiest player on the pitch, but two huge interventions. You know, and that's the life of the goalkeeper, isn't it? You know, you don't get that many opportunities to show what you can do necessarily, but crucial times, big saves. Manny Smith was up there. There's been a lot of good performances, but those two saves are crucial.
Jonathan Flatt signed a 2-year deal with Wolves in the summer. And the sponsors disagree because they made Andy Bishop.
Listen, there's a handful of players you could give it to. It's
and as you will have seen there, Elliot Durrell has replaced Jay Harris, who's played his part too. Just seeing the game. What have you made of Maidstone United, Barry?
Well, it's a snapshot, isn't it? But the fact of the matter is, they're looking. They've got games in hand. They're second. If they do anything akin to form with those games in hand, they'll be well clear at the top of their division. They're obviously having a fantastic season. They're full of confidence. They've got some good players in their midst, and I have to say, they've put up a fantastic effort tonight. With a credit to their division, two leagues below at Wrexham play, don't forget. So, nothing but impressed the way they've carried themselves, the effort, some of the skill, and the fact that, you know, they kept going forward has been really impressive.
having to defend against Louis Mott. This is their seventh game in the competition as well, of course, having beaten Stevenage in a replay of League Two in the last round. So they've had their FA Cup memories. It'll be a long journey home tonight, but full of pride still. Down to 10 men. They just refused to throw in the towel and kept their hopes alive until Andy Bishop got his second goal of the game in the last few minutes. Durrell, the substitute, is quick enough to catch that. Bishop was looking at a hat-trick then.
Decent ball in from Elliot Durrell. Possibly just a little bit low for Andy Bishop to get the contact he wanted.
Smith, who got it underway for Wrexham with that first half goal. Again, after Jonathan Flatt had made a crucial save at 0-0. Hence Barry Hall's decision for man of the match. And Wrexham have overcome a potential banana skin to beat Ryman Premier League side Maidstone by 3-1. Kevin Wilkin can look ahead to Monday night's third round draw in the hope of a money-spinning tie. Manny Smith put them on the way with a first half goal. Then Andy Bishop, a penalty after Aaron Simpson had been sent off, and then the goal to finally kill off Maidstone after Alex Fisher had given them hope. But it's been a heroic performance from Maidstone. Jonathan Flatt helped Wrexham through too. It could be such a vital win for the North Wales side as they look to return to the Football League, because if they get a big tie on Monday, then it could be a money spinner. Let's go to Dylan Griffiths on pitch side with Wrexham double goal scorer Andy Bishop.
Yes, Andy Bishop, a smiling Andy Bishop. Andy, this competition has been good to you this season.
Yeah, definitely. I think that's my fifth goal in three games. The boys did well. I thought credit to Maidstone, they give us a real good game. Fair play to them, and I wish them all the best for the season.
Yes, they showed real character, especially down to 10 men.
Yeah, definitely. We didn't expect anything different. The reports we've got on them, they worked hard, and that's what they did. They gave us a real good game.
Your second, the third, you sealed it.
Yeah, definitely. Pearsall's put an unbelievable ball in. It's harder to miss and score, so fair play to him.
Kevin, bring you in. The players showed a lot of character there tonight.
Yeah, everybody. I mean, both sets of players, you know, to get rocked back like that, Maidstone, great credit to them, like, to come out and still force the issue against us when they found it quite difficult. You know, they've had one or two opportunities there along the way, and great credit to them. They're a club on the up, and, you know, I'm delighted to be in the next round, but it was a fantastic tie, and both sides played in the right spirit, and like I say, we look forward to the draw Monday now.
That's the next question, Kevin. Who do you want in the third round?
Have a guess. I'm just happy to be in the next round. Anybody at home would be very, very nice.
Kevin, many congratulations. Enjoy the night, and thanks for joining us.
Thank you. Thanks.
Yeah, he doesn't mind at all who they get in the next round. It was a hell of a cup tie, wasn't it? And a deserved win for Wrexham, Dean.
Yeah, but it was a great game, and all credit to Maidstone. They've won seven games to get to this point, and they're live on TV. They've won a few quid. Brilliant performance from them, but I think Wrexham deserved to win at the end of the day.
Ewan, key second half moment this, the red card and the penalty.
Yeah, no option for the referee but to show the red card. That's the letter of the law. You know, he's through one goal. Once again, his pace, great run from Wes York. Maybe the initial contact was maybe just outside, but this is a good pen. You know, he's just missed a good chance 4 or 5 minutes before that penalty, and it's a terrific penalty. No chance for the goalkeeper with them.
Filcher pulled one back for Maidstone, so it looked as if they were back in it, but then Bishop wrapped it up.
Well, yeah, Andy Bishop scored goals in the league. He's always scored goals at a much higher level than this, and he's had a lot of bad injuries, but it's just shown tonight the difference between the levels they're playing at. Andy Bishop's run for the third goal was different class.
This will be a big boost for Wrexham. Ewan, briefly.
Well, they've got to take it into their league form now, haven't they? They've got Southport away on Saturday. Still only 5 points from the playoffs, so it's still all to play for. And they've got now this FA Cup third round draw to look forward to on Monday.
gentlemen. Thank you very much for your company here at the racecourse this evening. So Wrexham got there in the end. It was Bishop with the two goals in the second half to get them through. The draw is live on the BBC. BBC 2, Wales, on Monday night at 7 o'clock. 47 is Wrexham's number in the draw. From all of us, goodbye for now. Thanks for your company. Bye-bye.